Welcome to my YouTube channel, guys. Today I am with the most cheapest 200cc bike available in Indian market. It's the Hero Xtreme 200R. Comparing with other 200cc street bike, this bike is not overly muscular or sporty, but have a clean design thanks to the tank extensions. Otherwise, this bike will look lean. This bike look more like a 150cc bike. Actually, I like the rear section of this bike. The headlight unit is not that attractive. Coming into its hood, it got a 200cc 2-valve 4-stroke single-cylinder air-cooled carburetor engine paired with a 5-speed gearbox. The engine produces 18.4 PS at 8000 RPM and 17.1 Nm at 6500 RPM. The front got a telescopic suspension and stops with single disc with single channel ABS. And it got 100 bar 80 17 inch tires on alloy wheels. The back wheel stopped with single disc and got 130 bar 70 17 inch tires on alloy wheels. Seven step adjustable mono shock handles the rear suspension. Headlight and indicators are powered with halogen bulb and tail lamp is powered with LED bulbs. When you sit on the bike, on your right you can see engine kill switch, self start button, and your left side dim and bright with pass button, indicator switch with push button cancel and horn switch. You can also see the choke switch. Both the mirrors give good view, but not that great because you can see portion of your shoulder. The clutch is very light and smooth. And coming into the riding posture, it's not an upright riding posture. For upright riding posture, the handlebar must be in this level. You have to lean forward to grab the handlebar. Somewhat like a sporty cushion. Also, I felt like a small bend is given for the handlebar. Coming into the instrument cluster, it's a mixture of analog and digital meter. The tachometer is analog and all other details are provided in digital. The fuel gauge, speedometer, odometer, time, and also there is two trip meters. Only basic information is given on the instrument cluster. Also, you can see ABS, high beam, indicators, neutral, and side stand indicators. Actually, I like analog tachometer. It's just my personal liking. I will just show you and tell you why. I like this because when you ride the bike, see the tachometer needle moving upward, it just gives me a good feel. Let's go for a ride and check whether the bike is really extreme or not. The first thing you will notice when riding this bike is the engine is rev friendly. You can easily reach up to the red line. All the power lies in the mid range. You can feel that much power in low end. And the bike is also very comfortable thanks to the suspension. It's set up in the softer side, so it can easily take bad roads, bumps and potholes. I have already told the riding posture is set up into sporty and commuter type. You have to lean something forward to grab the handlebar, and also the foot pegs are somewhat rear, but not up to that. The bike is flickable and easy to filter through traffic. The MRF tires gives good grip on dry road, but not that great on wet condition. In corners, the suspension is set up in softer side, so in hard corners you will lose some confidence. And about the brakes, the brake gives good bite and the ABS is working good. The bike got only single channel ABS at the front, and the rear wheel locks up when you do hard braking. The rear wheel will skid when you push the pedal hard. Talking about the build quality, the fit and finish is average if you are comparing with its competitors. Seat is good for short rides. It's linear at the front and increases seat width. The seat height is 795 mm. Both will help short riders to touch both their feet on ground. This seat is not so hard or not so soft. It gives good support and comfort. For long rides, it's not that great. If you are fat, the seat won't give you that much support and comfort for both the rider and pillar. It's a high revving engine, so you will feel that it's a sporty bike, but actually its power delivery is very linear and you will feel the power only after 4000 rpm. But don't think that it will give a scary feeling after 4000 rpm. The best cruising speed on this bike is 80 to 90 km/h. After that you will feel that the engine starts struggling, and also you will feel some vibrations. The bike will give you a fuel efficiency of 34 to 36 in city riding condition and 38 to 42 in highway riding condition. You can feel lot of wind blasts because there is no proper windshield on this bike. At night riding condition, the headlight is not that great because the halogen bulbs are powered with AC power supply. So it will give you good illumination only if you touch the throttle. The bike is very lightweight. It only weighs 148 kg, and the tank capacity of this bike is 12.5 liter, and the bike got a ground clearance of 165 mm. When you sit on the bike and plant your foot on the ground, one thing disturbing you is its footrests. It will touch your leg, and when you have to move the bike with your legs, the footrest will fold. You can't compare this bike with other 200cc machines available in market because the price of this machine is only 1.10 lakhs. And for that price, you will be getting only a 150 or 160cc bike. The power figures are below 200cc bikes but greater than 150 or 160cc bike. If I have to conclude about this bike, it's not a head turner and also not a feature rich bike, but it's a good city bike and only affordable 200cc bike with good service network and low maintenance cost. It's the same engine which is coming in the X-Pulse also with different tuning. If you are planning to buy a 150 or 160cc bike, take a test ride of this bike also. I think this bike will not disappoint you. But don't get any high expectations. It's not a premium 200cc bike. Hope you guys like this video. If you have any doubt, please comment below. I will be replying. If you like this video, please click the like button and also share with your friends. Don't forget to subscribe my channel. I will be coming with a new video. Till then, ride safe and keep smiling.